Well, hello YouTube and welcome back to the channel. So it's been a few weeks now because I had to test the car very well, and in the meantime there's some mega news on the GR Yaris. So if you haven't done so already, please make sure that you subscribe to the channel and like the content, because this is the way you support me and get more content for yourself. Let's get to it. So the Nitron R3 has been on the car for now almost 3 weeks. And I've been to a track day and multiple tests, both alone and with our customers, on the rally special stage roads of Gran Canaria. What can I say about this? First of all, we decided for custom spring rates, and the spring rates we have here are 120 Newton meter in the front and 70 Newton meter in the rear. This is a much softer setup than what you would see on a circuit, on a track, of course, but it's what we need in order to cope with all the road cambers and with the B-roads that we go through here in Gran Canaria when we are doing our driving experiences. So how did my experience go in setting up this three-way Nitron R3 suspension, and how can this benefit from you? So first of all, I sourced the kit from Suspension Secrets that were very nice to me and already gave me a good baseline setup. This baseline was something I would say more oriented towards track use. And as you know, I want things the way I want them and I want them different. So I went through my own routine, starting from full stuffed and building a new setup that now is working very well for me. So what I do usually is I start from full soft and I go three clicks by three clicks, and the only thing I keep even usually is the high speed compression. High speed compression you can set, for example, at three clicks from soft, and this was an indication from Suspension Secrets and it works very well. If you happen to be bottoming out too much, you know that you need to make your high-speed compression a bit stiffer. If you are not bottoming out but you still feel you don't have the best wheel contact to the surface at all times, you may try to go to two clicks, but this is already pushing it quite a bit. Let's talk now of compression and rebound. So basically we are affecting the time that the car takes in order to go down into full compression of its weight on the spring in a corner. So you can start with compression and understand by raising this setting three clicks at a time when the car is actually starting to feel too dodgy on the steering wheel, and when it starts being, let's say, reactive to the potholes and the bumps, especially in the road. And in this way, you understand why where the car is in the right moment. Ideally, what you want to do is to find the point where you feel the weight of the car while turning the steering wheel. The steering wheel doesn't have to feel too immediate. It doesn't have to be too easy. And this you need to test in low speed, car speed, in medium and in high car speed, because it changes, it varies a lot, also because the weight increases exponentially with the speed in the car. So you want to make sure of that. Then we go to the rebound. The rebound is the one that has the biggest effect on how the car performs, because basically it's pulling the car up from the sides when you are turning the steering wheel. And also, one would say, okay, so let's just go full stiffness on the rebound. It's not so easy, because if you go very stiff, you will take away traction, because in the same way, the damper is not returning to its relaxed position, to the zero position, as fast as it would be needed. So your tires may overheat because of having less weight on the contact patch. Rebound, you feel more because it's more directly, let's say, connected to the steering feel that you have with the car. It also has a big increase until the let's say mid-corner phase of how the car feels, so you can differentiate between the front and the rear and how you set it up. But all in all, it is a fair and easy thing to do. Just remember that you go three clicks and three clicks. Now, once the car feels quite good, so the setup is working for you, okay, that's great. Now, if you have a quality setup like the Nitron R3, you can go one click by one click. I've been doing the last 10 days going one click or two clicks at a time until I found the best setup that works everywhere. Of course, it's always a compromise, but the compromise you get with a three-way suspension is much, much better than what you get with a one-way, especially on the bumps and potholes. And once you set it up, you just forget it and you can go. When the suspension dampers start to wear out on the other side, you do have the headroom to increase the settings in a way that you get back to where your sweet spot was. And make sure that every time that you change the settings, you write them down so you know exactly what clicks you have, and you write down your driving sensations, because this will help you to pinpoint what is going well and what could be improved. So I hope this was interesting on the suspension setup, and tell me in the comments if you want to know more about the GR Yaris. So, very big news. We had some months ago opened relationship of work with Samsonas Motorsport. Then with the move, with everything that has happened and setting up and everything, I was a bit late, but now the suspension is on order and is coming. We are also distributing this suspension, but before doing so, I want to do all the tests on myself and report back to you. So for how the car works and all of that. I'm expecting to receive the three damper solution in about 3 weeks from now. So very soon we're gonna see it on the car. And this is the dampers. Second topic, the turbo. So we had been running for a little time with a hole in an intercooler hose on the GR Yaris. And it was very difficult to pin down the problem because the hole was minuscule, but the turbo was over revving a lot. So of course, before it breaking, I wanted to check it out. And in fact, I saw that the main bearing was already leaking a little bit. So I reached out to our friends at TTE Engineering, the turbo engineers, and they decided to make a cooperation with me, and therefore they are sending me a TTE 500 hybrid turbo for the GR Yaris that we'll be installing and mapping, always with Ecotec and Acme Racing. And if we are lucky, if everything works out, we're gonna manage to map it on April the 8th. But this depends a bit on logistics and the shippings. So this is something else really to go looking for. Third thing about the GR Yaris is we installed the Kai shifter. Kai shifter on the GR Yaris is something that has already been, but I think I feel like it was the last really important thing left to do in this car to increase the pleasure of driving and everything. So it is done now, and everybody that comes for the driving experience can now enjoy it fully. So this is all for today, and please consider taking a vacation here in Gran Canaria and living this beautiful driving experience, because it is really awesome. We can make day packages, week packages, everything you request and demand. We are just here to serve you, and I would like to get in contact with you in real life. So see you soon. Ciao.